an ordinary day. People check bags with insecurity screens. Took their seats and the child at 16B. Would you stop crying because you were scared of flying? John put the hair over his face. And Jane in 3H turned on her reading light because she wanted to read. Intermittent coughs join the child's cries, scratchy throats, sleepy eyes, and the ding of the fastened seatbelt sign. The captain came on and said, "We'd arrive on time. Thank you for choosing our airline." If you could see beyond the pupils of their star-crossed eyes, your attempt to prevent their demise. It seemed like an ordinary trip. People's eyes got wide when the turbulence hit. They took their seats and the child, 16B, wouldn't stop crying because he was scared of dying. They put the masks over their faces. They were knocked around all over the place. And the lights came on and the captain sounded surprisingly calm when he said that they were going down. No flotation device could save them from the ground. They desperately tried to get their loved ones on the line, but there was no time. If you could see beyond the pupils of their star-crossed eyes, then you would see beyond the futile attempt to prevent their demise. It was an extraordinary day. Souls from the plane were shot into the farthest reaches of space. With the stars, magnetars, and nebulas, never seen up close by the rest of us. These two souls met at the edge of infinity, and they exchanged pleasantries. He said, "My name's John." And she said, "My name's Jane." On that plane, their ethereal vapor intertwined underneath the pulsar's flashing lights. Everything's moving ineffably fast, yet it takes billions of years for anything to happen. And even though they never see their family and friends again, they had each other. Starlight and sailed on solo. Their whole time on Earth, they were just waiting for their lives to begin.